Hi, it's Mr. Hodgson, lead practitioner of maths here at Turton School. I just wanted to do a short video for parents of students in year 10 and 11 to share some information for a few online resources, including a new one that we've recently bought into. The first one I'd like to talk about is the Sparx website, which replaces the old Hegarty website the school has used previously. Every student at Turton has a login to Sparx, even if they've not used it before, and it's one of the best resources we can recommend to aid in your child's revision for exams. To get logged on, we're going to Google Sparx Maths. Sparx is spelled S-P-A-R-X. And we're going to click on the second link down to the UK site. We're going to try and log in as a student. And when it asks us to search for the school, we're going to search for Turton School. It's usually the first one on the list when I've tried to log in before. They won't be given their password just yet, but they can set up their own password if they click Forgotten Sparx Login Details. And all they'll need to know is their first name, their last name, and the date of birth. So there's no logging into their emails or any of that stress to worry about. Once they're logged in, the website should look something like this. The top left tab, the compulsory one, is where they'll be set homework. So their teachers may choose to set them homework using this website as opposed to paper copies. So each of these homeworks has a set of questions in them that the teacher will decide themselves how many they'd like them to do. As you can see, I've set myself a piece here. And I've managed to complete that top one, giving myself 16% of the homework finished altogether. It'll only be marked as complete when you've got 100%. The reason for that is the website will help them through every single question, offering support in the form of videos when they get stuck. It will keep going back and asking them the similar questions and offering more and more support and more scaffolding until they manage to get those questions right and make that progress forward. There are some other options on the left-hand side. The XP boost allows your child to attempt similar questions to the homework that they've been set. They might be asked to do additional homework here as well, just to give them that extra boost. It also awards them the XP points that they can use as an incentive, you know, to try and get higher than their mates in the class, perhaps. The target one on the bit further down is similar, so they might be set personalized homework by their teachers. This is normally something a little bit more difficult and it'll be set as more of a challenge rather than as the main body of homework. The bottom one is a really important one because this is where they will come if they're being asked to revise independently. So for example, if your child's being set an assessment on solving equations, we'd like them to come down to this bottom tab, click on algebra, solving equations, and as you can see, there's a huge number of questions that they can attempt that get harder and harder as you go down and allow them to both strengthen and then deepen their understanding in this topic. So when we set revision as homework, we'll be able to see how well your child has interacted with this revision tool, how many questions they've attempted, how long they've been on for, and how far they got. We'll be able to monitor that on our side and then obviously ensure that your child is completing that homework if that's what we choose to set. The other website that we have access to, it's a free one, so there's no logging in, is the Corbett Maths website. So again, just Googling Corbett Maths, as you can see here, we have access to all these videos, practice questions, which are similar to exam style questions, and then textbook exercise, what we might use in class. This is another really great tool because it has the answers to exam questions, as well as the video solutions. Again, this is a completely free resource. There's no logging in. And this is what many teachers will use in the planning of their lessons as well. I hope you found this video informative. If you have any additional questions about the Sparx Maths or the Corbett Maths websites, please don't hesitate to drop me an email at hodgsont@turton.uk.com. Thank you.